A proserpine man is locked in a licensing wrangle with the state government to keep his pet saltwater crocodile. It's been in the family for 47 years, but now the government says public safety is at risk.
There's no doubting Charlie is a member of the family. She arrived as a hatchling after her mother was shot. John Casey was 2 then, now he's 49.
My father used to attend events in proserpine, fates, functions. We used to take the crocodile in there, just let her walk freely down the street.
The barramundi-loving 4-metre saltwater croc was recently left to John in his father's will. But when he went to get a permit in his name, John says the state government threatened to remove Charlie, claiming her enclosure isn't up to scratch and holidaymakers at the nearby caravan park are at risk.
It's never been a problem up until now since my father's passed away.
The family pet shot to fame in the 80s when she bit off a hand and lower arm of John's father, Alf, in a feeding accident, and he forgave her.
I suppose you've got a cat or a dog at home, and how do you feel about that?
It was at the time the movie Crocodile Dundee was released in the US. Alf was flown there to tell his story on talk shows. John fears if Charlie ends up on a farm, she'll be turned into shoes and handbags. There's also a growing demand for croc meat overseas as cuisine that is uniquely Australian.
The sustainability minister says she'll get snappy on a solution.
So I'm hoping that by working with him, we can actually ensure that all the requirements of the legislation are met.
These great mates hope so too. Renee Henry, 10 News.